Now, let's talk about some other aspects of these.
They're all getting coronavirus. Oh, you're gonna invoke RBG's name? You're getting the Rona. You're getting.
Well, that's a great transition, actually, because they probably are all getting coronavirus. So if we go to this first graphic, you can see Mike Lee is in the hearing room, and you can see him chatting with Lindsey Graham, and they're in front of Chuck Grassley. So hold for that for a little moment, because that is an amazing triumvirate right there. So you have Mike Lee with his mask pulled down below his nose. He was diagnosed with coronavirus 10 days ago. And there he is in person with his mask improperly put on, speaking with Lindsey Graham, who refuses to get tested, probably because he doesn't want to reveal that he already has it and he really wants to be there in that room so that they can get their Supreme Court justice. They're standing over Chuck Grassley, who is 173 years old and in the presidential line of succession and probably contracting coronavirus literally as we speak. But that's what they did because they don't have any respect for human life. They're pro-life, except for all the lives that they don't care if they let pass or not.
Oh, Chucky. Yeah, Chuck's just like, unbeknownst to him, just like germs are flying. They're all over his head. I love that. I will say, you know, just looking at this from the outside, you see we're in this moment where these senators are in danger. Lindsey Graham is in danger of his seat. That wasn't supposed to be a dangerous seat for the Democrats or for the Republicans to lose, right? That wasn't supposed to be in play. Now it totally is. And so are many other senator seats. So what I'm looking at is a bunch of soon to be losers pushing forward their soon to be loser president. Look, the polls are not good for Trump. I'm never gonna get cocky about this, but honestly, not looking good. And they're trying to just get it in on time under the, you know, before the bell rings on an issue, which again, Amy Coney Barrett would absolutely help overturn the ACA on an issue that is incredibly popular. You're gonna slide this Supreme Court justice nomination in at the last minute to do something that most Americans don't even want anyway. Whether it's Roe v. Wade, whether it's overturning the ACA, it's hard to see how this is a win. I'm not really sure who they're doing this for, what base they're truly trying to excite that hasn't already jumped ship from the Republican Party or hasn't already just like sowed completely their entire fate to Donald Trump.
Yeah, I mean, look, they don't have to answer for the fact that the policies they're trying to push for aren't popular because they're not even really pretending to care about democracy anymore. And Mike Lee, who we just talked about in that photo, he was the dude with the tweets last week saying we're not a democracy and democracy's bad, liberty is what's important. Like they know that their policies aren't popular. That's why they're lying about them right now. Every single Republican is saying she will follow the letter of the Constitution. She won't do any of the things you're saying. Those things like giving Trump a second term, overturning Roe v. Wade, overturning the ACA, which are literally the only reasons she was chosen. That is why she is the nominee. No, she definitely won't do that. And they're saying that because they know that all of those things are incredibly unpopular, but they're not. They're operating technically in the US, but under a different government, a different philosophy of government than we are. We're trying to operate a democracy. They're not. They're manipulating the system, which has been set up to make a white minority continuing rule possible. Yep. And they're riding that. They're riding that to a Supreme Court majority, a super majority, after several decades of them being effectively unable to compete nationwide. But they're still getting more and more power because the system is set up to benefit them, even if the population has no interest in that.
Yep, absolutely.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.